Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be a little bit different. We're gonna do a Q&A while I try on clothes that I recently picked up, whether it be Black Friday or things that I recently picked up from the latest KGMTL drop that I'm wearing right now. So let's get started because we have quite a few questions. Let's also just start off this video with a little Fendi unboxing. It is my rental from Coup Deluxe for the next 2 weeks. And I am the first one to borrow it. This is a Fendi bag that I have been wanting to get for ages, but I wanted to test drive it before I did the splurge. Oh, I have a feeling I'm gonna love it. I can tell already. Okay, there is a long strap, but you guys know me, it's useless in my book. Let's open this bad boy up. Oh my God, stop. Oh my God, this bag is beautiful. Oh my God, this bag is gorgeous. I borrowed it for the week from Coup Deluxe. You guys know I work with them and I love them. I think they are the coolest company. I love that this finally exists in Montreal. You can rent bags for 3 days up to a week, and sometimes I extend over a week, but I have a special night out this week, and I have a special little weekend date night planned, and I really, really, really wanted to carry this bag with the dress that I'm gonna be wearing. This is my Fendi first. It's Coup Deluxe's Fendi first, but I'm borrowing it for the week. This is what it looks like. Oh my God. Oh my God, guys. Ah, this is beautiful. So this is what it looks like. I'm gonna style this up this weekend and I'm going to put it on Instagram. So you guys need to, oh my God, it's beautiful. Oh my God, it's so beautiful. And of course it's Zooka lined. Oh my God. Fendi, seriously? Seriously, Fendi can do no harm in my books. Like honestly, it's one of my favorite brands in the whole world. Fendi first, okay. I have so many shoes and I just realized the only other black pumps I have are my black Lubes, which I can't wear them, they hurt too much. So I got these Saint Lo by Us. They're so comfortable. It's a collaboration between Saint Lo by Us and Mademoiselle Jules. Mademoiselle Jules, Julie being one of my friends. And she had told me, she's like, Mel, try these shoes. You are gonna love them. And I do. They give the longest, leanest legs you could ever imagine. Like I'll insert a picture right here, which by the way, the dress that I'm wearing here is also new. It's by KGMTL. It's her new short dress that's coming out. I think it's launching on Sunday. I'll link it down below. I have a code for the brand and everything. I also have a code for these. A lot of my friends work in fashion, so I get codes for their lines. So I have a 15% off code for these shoes and a 10% off code for Catherine's line. These are such a great, just basic, black pump. Okay, before I start changing, let's start. First question, how is the dynamic between Luca and your honey? I'm so happy for you. Thank you. Okay, so first dress we're gonna try on is this one over here by Mink Pink. The dynamic between Luca, is it awkward that I'm gonna be changing while I'm doing this? She was definitely ready to have someone in our life. Although she is very, very happy with our life as well. The dynamic between the two of them is really, 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 really good. They really get along. I think the fact that we dated in the past, my parents already knew him, like it definitely gave her trust. But I'm taking off my bra. So the dynamic between the two of them is absolutely incredible. He's really good with kids also, which also really helped. It was a very instant click as well. I feel like the fact that he entered our life as my friend versus my boyfriend, she really just opened up. Luca's always used to having like a bunch of friends around. We're always hosting, there's always people. So it wasn't a difficulty for her to accept him as a friend. And by the time I told her he was my boyfriend, she was like excited that the relationship had developed to a relationship, which it was a relationship when I introduced them, but I kept it as he's my friend. So they have a really good relationship, which makes everything so easy, because honestly, had it not been, had she told me, Mom, I don't like him, we never would have spoken again, regardless of my feelings, to be honest. My next question is not relationship related. You hustle. May I ask how many different streams of income you have? You're inspiring. Thank you. So I own a marketing agency. It's a digital marketing agency where I do website developments. I do Instagram, social media development and stuff like that for businesses. So I have that I work to 9 to 5. So that's my 9 to 5 job. It's always been my priority just because that's my, it's my career, you know? So that's one. Then social media. Then real estate, I own commercial and residential properties. So that is three. I'm trying to think, is there anything else? But everything else falls in those corporations. I work hard, but I really, really, really enjoy what I do for a living. So I always feel like I'm lazy because I feel like I'm not working enough, but I'm actually always working, if that makes any sense. We love you, Mel. I love you. Just wanted to say, love your mama vibes. You're always so upbeat, even if you're tired. Thank you. Thank you so much, because I am tired. I am definitely tired, but I do think, I really do believe in mind over matter. And even if you're tired, cheer yourself up, perk yourself up, give yourself energy, and your body kind of just follows and realigns. This is from Elan, and this is what I'm planning on wearing as a hostess for December 24th. I am hosting Christmas this year. I'm literally changing on YouTube right now. To be honest, I think what works in my favor, what made it a little bit easier, is the fact that Luca does not remember her dad and I together. She only knows me as a single mom because we split when she was 3. She doesn't remember life married. She doesn't remember living with her dad. She doesn't remember any of that stuff. So it kind of makes building a new relationship and introducing someone else a lot easier. Okay, wait, I have to show this dress. Oh my God, I'm obsessed with this dress. Oh my God, this dress is everything. And it has like the peeking open. Oh my God, this dress is so beautiful. I forgot how much I loved it when I first tried it on. Oh, this is gorgeous. Oh my God, it's beautiful. So let's start at the beginning with the relationship, how it worked out. So when we started talking, I knew right away, I think within a week of us talking, that this was not the normal talking situation. Like, I knew within a week this was going to develop into something serious. I'd started mentally preparing myself, like, okay, how am I gonna do this with Luca? So I started talking to Luca and I started saying, like, hey, I bumped into my friend that I went to high school with, and I told my parents, obviously, and my sister. And we would talk on like Sunday night dinner and be like, I bumped into my friend, and like we saw each other. So Luca kind of felt like she was invested in the relationship. And I was like, would you like to meet him? And my mom and dad and sister played into it, and they were like, oh my God, yes, I remember him. He was amazing. We all loved him so much. So we played in to the friend factor. And then by the time November rolled around, like end of November, I was like, okay, it's time to introduce Luca. Like by end of November last year, I was like, if you guys haven't seen the how we met and how our relationship started, I will link it down below, just because this video is gonna make a lot more sense to you. So after like my mom and my sister would like talk about him, Luca felt really confident. She was like, oh my God, I totally want to meet this guy. And I was like, okay, well, give it some time and maybe we can do something eventually. And eventually ended up being end of November, early December of last year, 2022. I feel like when you're our age, you know when you know. I think I knew within a week that this was my person, and that dating door and anything for me, any other options or any other people out there, nobody would compare to him. He ended up coming over, and I had asked Luca, I said, what would be the thing you want to do the most in the world? Like, what would make you the happiest right now to do? She's like, I want to do a peanut butter sandwich, which we use Wow Butter because I'm allergic to nuts. But she's like, I want to do the peanut butter challenge that I saw on YouTube where you make faces with fruits on toast. So I was like, okay, let's do that. And I was like, well, do you want me to invite him and we can do it all together? And she's like, yes. So he came over for just a few hours and we did the peanut butter challenge on toast. We all made ourselves in toast format. We had such a fun afternoon, and by the time he left, she was like, oh my God, he's so nice. We should invite him to have Christmas with us. I basically left the ball in Luca's court. Like, Luca kind of dictated if she wanted to see him again, when we were gonna see him, and I never pushed him on Luca. I never told her she needed to like him. I really just kind of let her feel out. Honestly, he's possibly one of the nicest people I've ever met in my life. Even back in high school, like everybody, like my parents used to be so in love with him because he was so nice. And I knew that Luca would just like be won over by him. So I trusted the process. He ended up coming over for Christmas last year with his family, because if you guys have seen the other video, you guys know that we grew up together. So our families already knew each other. We all knew each other. So it was just kind of like a natural progression to just do Christmas all together, because it was just like, hey, we're back, you know? And like my cousins were there. My cousin was like, oh my God, bro, you're back? What? So it was kind of like a relaunch to the relationship, which was really, really nice, to be honest. But it was all a very natural, slow-paced, chill vibes, and it just worked out that way. So Luca was very welcoming to who he is. I remember Luca teasing me that he was, I was about to say his name, that he was my boyfriend before I had even told her that we were a couple. And she was like, oh my God, you totally love him. So when I think I told her in like February that we were an item, and she was like, oh my God, this is like best news ever. So she was really receptive. Okay, so many questions. I'd love to know how you introduced him. I'd love to know how you introduced him. How does Luca feel about your relationship? She's very, very happy. But like I said, I only introduced her once I knew, like, put a ring on it, I'll say yes, let's spend the rest of our lives together, to be honest. Otherwise, I don't know she would have felt as secure about the relationship if we were kind of iffy. Like, we are very, very solid. We are both very, very level-headed, emotionally balanced individuals. So there's no ups and downs. It's very just like a very constant, safe space relationship, which, oh my God, guys, if you have not found out yet, oh my God, it is one of those game changer moments in life where you're just like, oh my God, you're not gonna scream and yell? What? You're not gonna lose it? I have never been used to this kind of relationship, and it's like, for me, and like, it's so healthy for Luca to witness a relationship like this. How long did you wait to introduce Luca? Why, when, etc. I think you just heard all the details. It was relatively quick, but it's just because we had so much history already, and I felt like you didn't really need to. I knew who he was, you know what I mean? Like, and I know to my family, they were like, oh my God, Luca needs to meet him, like, now. Like, to them, it would have been like within 2 weeks, like, because my mom was that sure we were gonna get married when I was 16 years old. Like, that's the type of relationship we had. No question, just contente de te voir épanouie et heureuse. Merci. Is your man into luxury fashion, or is he more simple, wears whatever? It's a phenomenal question. And on that note, let me show you something else I'm gonna try on. Next off is this dress by Cami NYC. I got this for a client's dinner that is next week. It's like a black tie, but fashion industry style dinner. So it's like, be fancy, but be edgy at the same time. I feel like it's an Angelina Jolie moment type of dress. You'll get it as soon as I put it on. So he is a uniform dresser, if that makes any sense. Like, literally, he will wear jeans and a sweater, jeans and a t-shirt. For work, he wears like suits and stuff like that. He works in finance, so he like has to wear like suits and like dress pants and like sweaters and stuff like that. Ooh, I have to zip this from the front. My boobies are too big. But he has the luxury vibes in him. Like, you can tell it's something that he's interested in, he could dabble in. Like, he likes watches, like high-end watches, he'll do that. But he's not a guy who's dated a girl like me before with the like designer stuff and stuff. He's not that guy. But you can tell that he's into that stuff. Oh my God, You could tell he's really into that stuff and he could possibly become one of those guys, but he's not at core. Like, he's into fashion, but he's not like a slave to fashion. He's not one of those guys. Whoo! This is gorgeous. Oh, this is gorge. Oh my God, this is so gorge. Oh my God, I love it. Holy, this is gorge. Oh my God, I love this dress. I keep forgetting how gorgeous they are. Oh my God, this is beautiful. So back to the boys. You could tell he loves this stuff, but he loves that I am like that, that I'm that girl. Like, you could tell he really appreciates that I dress up, that I do the shoes, that I do the makeup, the hair. Like, you could tell he loves that I'm a girly girl. And that was something from our past relationship also. I've always been like this. Like, my nails are always done. My hair is done. My makeup, like, you can tell he really appreciates that, which it feels good, because to have someone appreciate that you put in the work and you put in the effort, it's nice to see that somebody appreciates that. How did Luca react when you introduced him as your boyfriend? Love you always. So he wasn't introduced that way. He was, I mean, you heard the story. So he was just my friend who, basically, she told me to make him my boyfriend. Will you show his face? I will absolutely not, but you'll have to trust me. He's a cutie. Very, very cutesy. Tan skin, black hair with a little bit of salt and pepper. He's a cutesy. He's definitely my type. You mentioned your house being big. Is your boyfriend going to move in? Probably, yes. Does your boyfriend have kids too? He has two. So that is what I have in terms of dresses, but I did some outerwear shopping, so we're gonna go hard on that. The last question that I read, sorry, as I'm tying my bra, is what are your future plans? Do you guys have your future planned out? We have, I mean, we definitely have both spoken like this is it for both of us. I am not interested in meeting someone else. He is not interested in meeting anyone else. And it's kind of, I mean, I feel like there's no other way of saying it. It's a forever thing for me, and it is for him too. And I feel like we both feel very blessed, both acknowledging how blessed we are to have come into each other's lives again, because to be honest, I never thought it would have happened. This was completely out of left field. It was not something on my radar. I consider myself incredibly lucky that we were able to reconnect, and that 23 years later, different paths, different lives, different everything, and we still have that spark that we had when we were kids. Like, it's insane to me. I just feel like I was never one to believe in like soulmates and stuff like that, but I feel very lucky that all this happened. This outfit, the leggings, are the new KGMTL leggings, which are absolutely insane. I'm gonna insert a video that I took yesterday because I don't wanna back up the camera again, but this top, these leggings, like the seamlessness on here for me is what's mind-blowing. I just find it's the ultimate active look. Coat that I wear a lot, that I have been getting a lot of questions of what brand it is. It's from Bagatelle from a million years ago, but I can't find it anymore. It's not available, but I did find this Jackie puffer that for me was very, very similar. I got it in the brown. It comes with a hood, which is an added bonus for me. It is the exact same fabric, that like faux glossy leather, as my other one that you guys love so much. It's very, very similar in terms of vibes. That's why I picked it up, because I wanted to show it to you guys. And I actually like the brown over that caramel color that I have, but now I have both. So I love that. I love the hood. I love how it sits. It does this like, I don't know. I just find it such a great fit, and I got it on Black Friday sale. So I was like loving it. This one's also by Jackie. I've been getting so much feedback from you guys, and that I look happier and I look peaceful and I look really joyful. And I have to say, I've been really happy just being like a single mom for the past almost 4 years. And being with Luca 24/7 and having that relationship that her and I have, I wouldn't trade it for the world. And I truly am so content, just the two of us, that if that would have been the rest of my life, I would have been so happy just like that. But I have to say, meeting him again and having our life together, all of us together, for me has just kind of, this coat is everything. I love this. But yeah, so for me, him being in our lives, our families kind of mixing in together and blending and all that stuff, it is just, it's the added bonus that I didn't know I needed, if that makes any sense. He completes, I feel like he puts a certain peace and security in my life that is just so, I don't know, it feels just so stable and healthy. And it's so appreciated after going through such a storm and having such turmoil and uncertainty, after all the chaos that I've been through in relationships, that like craziness, it's just so nice to meet someone with the same energy of just peace and calm and emotional maturity. Like, it just, he's the piece of puzzle that we were missing, I think. That was the end. That concludes the end of my haul and my Q&A, because most of the Q&A questions were literally the same. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video and a little insight on our life together and what hopefully many, many years to come of happiness will look like. So make sure to thumbs up this video if you haven't already, subscribe if you're not, and I don't have anything else to say besides I love you so, so much, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye, guys. Mwah!